A new study published in the British Journal of Psychiatry suggests women who are stressed during pregnancy are in some cases up to 10 times more likely to have a child with a personality disorder. I kind of hate talking about this because I can see pregnant women out there right now stressing out about hearing this headline. So in the study, they followed over 3,000 people in Helsinki, Finland that were born in 1975 and 1976. After 30 years, they tracked how many of them had personality disorders. And the researchers did find that those who were exposed to extreme maternal stress were up to 9.53 times more likely to develop a personality disorder. Now, if the mothers just had a moderate amount of stress, 3.59 times more likely. Mm-hmm. And it probably this element, we talk hormones all the time on the show, but a chronic stress state is so different than I'm acutely stressed because I need to fix a situation. Yes. Chronic stress leads to elevated cortisol. Elevated cortisol at all times is a very bad thing. Yeah. Inflammation, high blood pressure, like so many elements of it. So it kind of makes sense that extreme maternal stress would put stress on the developing baby. Who knows what that looks like 10 years down, 20 years down the road.
Yeah, I agree. When we're talking about stress in pregnancy, remember that your baby's brain is developing, and I think undoubtedly stress can impact the development of a baby's brain. I like this study, but in the study, they didn't account for things like trauma during childhood and like financial situations and other things that could have an impact on a child as they're growing into an adult, meaning they didn't account for all of the factors that can contribute to the development of a personality disorder. So once again, love the study. Definitely think there is something to this, but I would like to see more research about this.
So Kelly, I want to go back to you since you're here. If you're a woman considering becoming pregnant, are pregnant, what can you do when you read a study like this? Because again, if you're stressed, last thing you want to do is be stressed about another headline that tells you your stress is bad for you and your baby.
So don't stress about stress. So I'm not surprised about this study. You know, we've known for a long time all the things you were saying, that cortisol can lead to, you know, developmental problems, both physically and mentally. What this study is telling us is a little different. And I want to say that for people that might not really understand what cortisol is, it's an extremely important hormone that we need. And, you know, it helps with lung development in utero. At the same time, too much of it can be almost poison, you know, too much in us. So we know that personality disorders can equate to high intensity reactions. Mm-hmm. And cortisol is there to give us high intensity reactions. Mm-hmm. So the way that sort of translates for children is that you're in utero and you're being bathed in cortisol all the time. So as your brain is developing, you know, it's sort of getting used to that high intensity way of being. And then you just fast forward out 10 years like they did with the study, and you have these little 10-year-old people who are having high intensity reactions to things. And it's not just personality disorders. We also know that it can be depression, anxiety, ADHD. There can be a lot of outcomes.
So what do you recommend to control the stress response, at least to a point where maybe it's not affecting baby or bathing the baby in cortisol all day long?
Just making women aware is a huge piece. You know, we do almost universal testing now for depression throughout pregnancy and postpartum as well. I would love to see us also just be asking general environmental questions about stress. And then another piece would be to help women keep doing things that you love. Sometimes, and I can speak for myself, when you get pregnant, it's sort of like, oh, everything has to change. I'm not myself anymore. But that's not helping, because all the things you do to take care of yourself, you know, whatever those things might be, you need to keep doing them to whatever degree is acceptable for you. And, you know, the most important thing might be to get support. To ask for the support you need, whether that's with the people around you, at your job, your family, if that's an option for you. But also, if those aren't options for you, seek professional help. Talk to your physicians, talk to a therapist. We're here.
And the other element to that is, do not feel guilty about spending time for yourself, because ironically, you are doing things to benefit your child, your children.
Yes.
Being selfish is actually the most unselfish thing you can do in many ways. And I like that you brought that up. I really appreciate you being here today to talk about these important topics when it comes to women's health.